battles continues now at Nations Cup in the ISU Grand Prix of Figure Skating. And here once again are my colleagues Terry Gannon and Susie Wynn.
All right, Andrea, thank you very much. The free dance about to get underway. 4 minutes in length and worth 50% of the overall score. And to get us underway here, Isabelle Delabelle and Olivier Schoenfelder of France in sixth place going into this portion of the competition.
Starting off with a very tricky balance move. Takes a lot of practice.
Always nice to get an applause before you even start your program. This team, the number two team in France. Remember, the reigning world champions, Anacina and Pézerat, were the gold medalists in the French national championships. Not bad company.
The required elements. In this free dance, one of them is a twizzle sequence that just went by. Skaters. They both have a lot of flexibility and strength. They're equally matched. Oftentimes you'll find that one skater is better than the other and it really stands out.
Train in the city of Lyon in France. Isabelle lives with her sister, Véronique, who is also an ice dancer.
And they oftentimes compete against one another, and you can't tell them apart, but this year you'll be able to. Isabelle just had her hair cut.
Wonder if they ever switched positions and skated with the other partner.
I know, that would be an interesting concept. Twizzle sequence, difficult because they're changing feet, changing the parts of the blade that they're using.
And as you've taught me, a twizzle is just a fancy way to say turning on one foot.
You got it, Terry. See? You're a quick study. Difficult, great balance. I thought they had a very good skate. This is the first time out this season. It's a very complicated free dance, filled with lots of difficult lifts and balance moves.
Been together for 10 years now, steadily moving up the ranks from 19th to 14th to 11th at last year's World Championships. Isabelle Delabelle and Olivier Schoenfelder. will check their marks, and then the top four teams will be on the ice, and only three can make the podium as Nations Cup continues here on Lifetime.
This Lifetime Sports presentation.
The top teams getting set to decide who stands on the podium in ice dancing here at Nations Cup. Skate America champions Barbara Fuster-Poli and Mauricio Margaglio are currently in first place. The newlyweds, Margarita Jobiasco and Povilas Vanegas, are in second. And the surprise of the original dance and the home team here in Germany, Kati Winkler and Rene Losa, are third right now. And to get things underway, it will be the team looking to move up in the hearts and minds of the judges, Shane Linborn and Victor Kratz. We asked them if they're looking for a specific finish here.
We're looking for a specific skate here. We're looking for better than practice, even better than that. And we want to end the program feeling proud.
An entirely new outlook now for Shaylin and Victor. After a disappointing season last year and the knee surgery toward the end of last year for Shaylin, a lot of change, including the new coach, Tatiana Tarasova, who has said time and again to this team, this year skate as if it's your last time out there. That is the theme this season for the four-time world bronze medalist from Canada.
The music is March With Me, the story of ups and downs in life and in skating, and getting through them successfully.
Marks for Delobelle and Schoenfelder of France, 5.1 up to 5.6 overall.
They've come into the season more prepared than ever, and their confidence is starting to shine through.
Victor Kratz has battled a cold here in Germany, which has been, I guess, a little bit worse than they've led everyone to believe. So he's okay to go here, though. In a heated battle with the German team, Winkler and Losa trying to move up from fourth to grab a spot on the podium.
Their free dance has always been an area of strength for them. So it could be that they could move up here in the free dance and keep up their speed.
Do they look as fast as they did in the original dance to you?
No, it looks like they're holding back. Either I've talked about this a little bit with their posture. Their upper body carriage is a little bit dropped forward. And when you do that, you lose a lot of speed and unison. Sometimes that happens when you're nervous. You pull into yourself instead of opening up the chest muscles.
Thank you.
step up from last year, a big step up. I think another year, and they're going to be getting much more comfortable in their new situation.
Tatiana Tarasova, their new coach, who also, of course, you know, coaches the Italians, Cipollina Margaglio. So Shaylin Bourne and Victor Kratz wanting to cause a buzz, cause a stir in the world of ice dance, coming back after the disappointing slip last year and the knee surgery for Shaylin. A medal here would start to do that.
Really, they just need to keep working hard, keep concentrating on their posture, their basic skills, and all those things will happen for them. Well, they've always been great with highlight moves. A very beautiful lift. He's in a spread eagle position. Great balance move there. No hands. Nice transition. Now, they looked a little slow in their footwork. This footwork is hard. There are quite a few turns that Shaylin is doing, and those can slow you down. It takes a lot of training to keep that moving and flowing. But the difficulty's there, and that's a good sign.
So we will see what the judges think in a moment. There's the panel of seven. Interestingly enough, there is no Canadian judge on the panel. That certainly could come back to hurt them.
Well, in the original dance, there was a 4-3 split with the German team, Winkler and Losse. So that's when you really need your judge pushing them. It'll make that difference.
Absolutely. Victor really hurting right now. We talked about the cold. Technical merit marks, 5.2, a wide range. Look at the high mark. The 5-7.
Well, 5-2 low with the Lithuanian judge. It's a little too low.
Lithuanian still to skate here. Presentation marks coming now. There they are in the 5-6, 5-7
race. Those are some nice marks. There's certainly room for the Germans, but they skated this well.
So Bourne and Kratz into the lead right now. Will it be enough to keep them on the podium here, though? We'll see. Up next, the world bronze medalist will take the ice. At the Nations Cup competition, Terry Gannon, Susie Wynn ringside as Margarita Drobiazko and Povilas Vanegas take the ice. The newlyweds and reigning world bronze medalist currently in second place, and Povilas's mother, Lila, is here watching.
They're dancing to a tango and the more traditional free dances that we'll see. Great turns and twizzles. They're very precise, very exact.
Skater and a six-time Lithuanian national champion. And back in 1988, he may have been presented with the biggest no-brainer of a decision yet. He was drafted into the Soviet Army and was given the choice, either continue to skate as a career or go into the Army.
I don't know.
He chose the ice.
Sometimes with ice dancing, it might be better to go into the military. When you ask anyone who has skated to a tango, they'll say it's exhausting because the music has a tension within it, and your body feels that same tension. You have to keep very strong and held throughout. because of the nature of the dance. Footwork. It's very staccato. They're intertwining their legs, which makes it harder. This dance was very sharp, it was crystal clear.
Ross's mother, Leva, who used to coach him, by the way, when he was a young kid, very happy about what just took place on the ice. We've talked about the Italians, Fuscioli, Margaglio, what they did last year, moving up so quickly. Well, look at this team. They jumped from sixth to third at the World Championships in 1 year. That's unheard of for the most part in ice dance.
Well, and they've deserved it. They really have. It's nice to see and being appreciated. Let's take a look at their footwork. Just watch how close. Now this kicking back and forth can be dangerous. You're so close to one another's skate and shins. But that's what the tango is about. Very tight and close footwork. And then their change of edge lift. Beautiful quality. His feet are nice and tight. Beautiful depth of edge and shape through her upper body. And now they go to a nice low line. This is hard. This is at the end of the program to be that low. Your legs are already burning. But they didn't look tired at all.
Well, it's one thing to have to skate in front of the judges and on television, but to skate in front of your mother, now that is pressure.
Or your mother-in-law.
That's true. First set of marks now. 5.6 to 5.8. That's the range.
Well, I think those are fair marks. Still a little room to grow on, but a very difficult program indeed.
Margarita grew up in Moscow, got Lithuanian citizenship for Pogovas, but they still train in Moscow. Presentation marks and all first place ordinals from the judges. They're in the lead. Right now, let's go over and join Andrea Joyce.
Terry, just a few moments ago, this was Victor Kratz, able to catch his breath and make his way to the dressing room.
Hey, look, I got all the flowers from everybody. It's kind of cool, eh?
Meanwhile, his partner, Shaylin Bourne, is back in the arena, ready to watch Kati Winkler and Renee Losa. Only one of those teams will win a medal. We'll find out which when we return. The ISU Grand Prix of Figure Skating continues on Lifetime for the next 3 weeks. We'll be in St. Petersburg for the Cup of Russia next Friday night, on to Paris for Trophée Lalique in 2 weeks, and we'll wrap up our season in northern Japan with the NHK Trophy Friday night, December 22nd, so be sure to get your shopping done before then. Next on the ice tonight in Germany, the home team, Kati Winkler and Renee Losa. And the most interested spectator right now is Shaylin Bourne. This figures to be the battle for the bronze here at Nations Cup. Let's send you back now to Terry Gannon and Susie Wynn.
Thank you very much, Andrea. You can tell by the reaction from the crowd. The German national champions on the ice, Kati Winkler and Renee Losa, in third place. They would love to stand on the podium.
Go down,
the theme of their program is a message of hope. They're both oppressed plantation workers. By the end of the program, they're freed from the chains of slavery.
Shailene Bourne and Victor Kratz will be watching this very closely. Remember, they're in fourth, right behind Bikla and Losa after the original dance. It's that battle for third place and the bronze medal.
They certainly have great flow and speed, but some of their handholds and positions are a little bit easier, so it's easier to get that speed.
Dancing on television, it really didn't exist in what was then East Germany, decided that's what I want to do. They recruited Rene Losa, they got the ISU rule book and decided to teach themselves this sport. And here they are in the year 2000.
The things you can accomplish in such a short amount of time. But well done.
You saw Drobiosko, and Vonnegut watching the entire program. And somehow, you know, they have a chance to medal here, which would be a great thing for them. No matter what place they're in, you never find people out in the hall getting a cup of coffee when they're on the ice. Usually the place is packed. Everybody's in here watching them skate. Kathy Winkler and Rene Losa.
And they really have beautiful lifts. Very easy entry. And the exits are very seamless here. Very well skated. Now their footwork was nice and fast, but they are a little bit far apart and the difficulty isn't there.
Come on.
Will it be the Germans? Will it be the Canadians who will stand on the podium as the bronze medalist? Here's the first set for technical merit, 5.4 up to 5.6.
Well, some of these low marks would reflect the lack of difficulty. They're just a little bit lower than Born and Kratz.
And now the second set in a similar range, and those are definitely lower than those of Shailene Bourne and Victor Kratz. So the Canadians jump ahead into that higher spot. They've got the best chance of standing on the third step of the podium. Fusopoli and Morgaglio are next. Tio Morgaglio in first place heading into this portion of the competition. They're not only the reigning world silver medalists, but also one of the most emotional and expressive teams out there. There's a reason for that. It comes naturally. They're from Italy.
Milan, Italy is hot. On the outside, the hip and beautiful are common folk. Fashion is religion, and shoes are treated like crown jewels. For Italy's only world-recognized ice dancing team of Barbara Fusopoli and Maurizio Morgaglio, Milan, Italy is just a place called home. A home like any other, with family and friends. But you have to remember, this is Italy. Everyone is family.
Italian people has this kind of emotional inside. It's like passion people, you know. They are really hot. We have this Italian feeling, and all the people can see, and all the people say, why you are like this? Because we feel like this.
We try to give ourselves to the public, and every skater tries to do that. But of course we're Italians, and we try to do that more.
But last year, after beating Canadians Shailene Bourne and Victor Kratz at the Cup of Russia, Fusopoli and Morgaglio learned that skating is not always a pleasant affair. Mad at their loss, the Canadians were less than gracious.
I guess you can't let it get to yourself too much. You gotta keep things in perspective, but I honestly don't understand it, and I wish I did.
Yeah, can somebody explain that to me?
I was mad because I think all the skaters are good, you know, and all the skaters work very hard for this sport. In that competition, the judges prefer me and Maurizio, and in the season, we were good.
Maybe they didn't expect me and Barbara so strong. We were very strong inside. What they said after, their problem is not our problem.
But such is life, and this year, life has been good for Barbara.
I was married in 24 June. After 10 years together with my boyfriend, I met him in the ice rink many, many years ago, like 20. We never be friendly, never. Always mad and, you know, fighting. In Italy we say, if you fight, it's love.
Maurizio is just moving in with his girlfriend. On his day off, they went shopping for their new apartment. And of course, gelato.
That's very good before practice.
And the relationship on the ice has been just as sweet.
And normally all the people say, you are the couple, because you stay always together. We have a different life. He has a girlfriend and I have a husband, so it's different.
Maurizio and Barbara take their relationship seriously. Well, sometimes.
I'm a psychologist. I need it because I'm mad. No.
Yes, that is their psychologist. Even ice dancers occasionally need a bit of counseling.
We talk about everything.
Yeah, you can talk about everything. We can talk more with freedom. And yes, that's very good because sometimes the problem in a couple is the communication. So you have maybe problems to explain something or to say something to your partner. Of course, the psychologist is the people who can make the bridge.
Being together has its ups and downs for Barbara and Maurizio. So the question is, as for any couple, after their careers, can they still be friends?
Of course.
The experience is our life for many years. The best way will be to stay together also after. Of course, we don't know about the future, so maybe we will have different ways, and we will go to, I don't know, different place, different jobs. Still, we will have a kind of feeling always running with us.
Well, a team that has certainly grown throughout the years and grown closer. And great to hear them talk about how honest they can be with each other on and off the ice, and they've certainly brought that to their skating. Barbara Fusser-Poli, Maurizio Margaglio of Italy in the lead heading into the free dance. The reigning world silver medalists with designs on number one this year.
Picture Romeo and Juliet, the 1996 version.
Somewhere within the body of this free skate, Romeo and Juliet get into a motorcycle crash, so you know it's not the original version.
Very powerful turns from Barbara. They told me that it was hard to come up with ideas for this year. Last year, their Braveheart and Riverdance program was such a success. Really, when you hit a winner, it's hard to come back the next season on that same level. This program and this music, it has a hard edge to it. And although I love them as a couple, just find out it's a little hard to digest. And there's your crash, Terry.
Uh-oh. The lady who has had the biggest impact on this event has seen Shailen Bourne and Victor Kratz move up a spot to stand on the podium, and now hoping that Fusser-Poli and Margaglio can take the top spot and wear the gold medal.
passion with them wherever they go. I'm just not sure that this program is the correct vehicle for them to push out the world champs, Anacina and Pesara.
Their coach, Tatiana Tarasova, yeah, she likes it from the sidelines, I would say. You know, you watch this couple, and there are times when you think, boy, this is a little bit over the top. This is a little bit overdone. Mm-hmm. But the more you're around them,
you fall in love with them.
Well, you realize it's genuine enthusiasm.
It really is. It's not forced.
It's them. Barbara Fusser-Poli and Maurizio Margaglio.
They're very smooth here in this lift. He's in a nice low line, great balance. And they incorporate and bridge their choreography from the lift right into a dance spin. And entering into the final lift of the program. Looks difficult, but boy, there's the passion and the love of dancing right there.
Still not off the ice. They've collected all the flowers they can, but here are the marks already from the judges. Technical merit, those are very high, sis.
Those are very high. The 5-9 may be a little too high.
And now the presentation marks extremely high as well. In fact, those 5-8s and 5.9s, was there ever a doubt? Barbara Fusser-Poli and Maurizio Margaglio pick up another win in the Grand Prix of Figure Skating. They are the gold medalist here in Germany. Drobiazko and Vanagas of Lithuania, the reigning world bronze medalist, finished right behind with the silver. And born in Kratz, able to move ahead of the German national champions, Winkler and Rosa, to capture the bronze medal here.
Barbara, Maurizio, your second win of the Grand Prix, your feelings thus far?
Yeah, it is. We're happy we just finished, huh? But it was much better than Colorado. Maybe because here it's city and it's not altitude, but we feel good. New look, new costume, and everything was good. I'm happy.
And yourself?
Yes, we get the ticket for Tokyo today, so sounds good, and for the final, and we did a really good job, and we're absolutely happy to win in Germany. Personally, because my girlfriend is from here.
All right.
But then because it's our first victory here.
It's so, first time here.
So we're very happy. And after America, they were so good with us, the Americans and the Germans too today. So we're just to say thank you to all the public around the world.
Okay, well, congratulations. Thank and you. Let's go over to Andrea Joyce.
Okay, bye.
All right, thank you, Peter. Barbara and Maurizio are the first ice dance team to qualify for the Grand Prix final in Tokyo. They take their second gold medal of the season. The silver, meantime, went to the newlyweds, Drobiazko and Vanagas. While the comeback continues for Shaylin Bourne and Victor Kratz. An important bronze medal here, and they're standing by now with Peter Cruthers.
Shay and Victor, you came into this competition not so much looking for results, but a certain level within your skating. Did you reach that level in the performance?
Most definitely. I mean, I think skated better here than Skate America, and that's our goal for the whole season, just to skate strong in every performance and do the best we can.
Did you feel that, Victor?
Oh, it was great. I mean, our first competition was in Skate America, and that was high altitude, and it was the first time we skated the program. This time it's like sea level, and it's the second time we skate, so there's a whole lot more confidence going into this program, and it was just great to be back again.
Well, congratulations and continued luck in the season.
Thank you very much.
Still to come tonight, pairs. The Russian world champions are here but look vulnerable. And the French would like to take their place at the top. And how do you come back from a frightening fall? Danielle Hartzell has to answer that question tonight. The pairs competition at Nations Cup. Much more than gold on the line when we continue here on Lifetime.